Hey, John Sanmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got this question that's a fairly long question about basically how to start a project. So I thought instead of directly answering that question, which I'll probably do a blog post that will have more details on that question exactly later, but instead of directly answering that question, I would talk in more general terms about how I think that one should run an agile project from the start to the finish, and that'll probably answer a lot of the questions that were in that email. So, basically, you know, how do I think that you should start an agile project, right? From the beginning phase of the gathering requirements to building it in order to be successful, especially in a sort of corporate environment where you have stakeholders and you have users and you have all of this kind of politics going on. You know, obviously things are never going to be ideal, but I'm going to pitch to you kind of what I think is the ideal, and so you can see. And this is going to be based on not just me just coming up with this from anywhere, but from working as a scrum master in some very large multi, tens of million dollar projects, as well as consulting a lot of companies on agile practices and coming in and helping them to organize and be successful. So where I would start, right, the very first place to start is to understand the existing system very, very well, right? I'm talking in terms of revamping a current system. Most of the time we're trying to revamp something that already exists, right? There's already some software for something. So that's where I would start, is what does the existing system look like? If there isn't one, then obviously you're not going to do that step. Then I would go and I would spend time doing the job of the actual person who is going to use the software as much as possible. Now, this isn't possible in some places, but in most places, right, let's say that you work in a corporate environment, can you actually sit at your user's desk and do their job for like probably a week, honestly? I know this is gonna be kind of hard to get sign off on, but this is critical. If you can be the person who's using the software and helping to design and build that software at the same time, this is going to save you a lot of going back and forth over the course of the project. So I'd recommend that if you're starting a project like this, that you try to get the developers and the QA people, at least a few of them, working as the actual workers who would be using the software, or if you have existing software at least, and if you don't, then doing the manual process that they're doing now and do that for preferably a week, at least a day, right? A full time. I'm talking, just pretend like you are an employee working in this job role. That's going to be extremely, extremely effective down the road. Seems like a waste of time right now. Okay, so once you've done that, then the next thing to do is, well, obviously at this point, if you've actually done that, you're going to have a really good idea of what the user needs and what the application should do. But you don't want to try and build this whole thing, right? We're going to do this in an agile way. So what we're going to do is we're going to focus on sort of looking at kind of a few big milestones, kind of this really, really big zoomed out view of what the application should do. And then what we want to do is we want to break it down and basically say, okay, what is the minimal viable product, this MVP, right? What is the smallest thing that we can build that would be of use at all, right? And start there. We're not going to worry about the architecture and all the other stuff. We'll think about it a little bit, right? But when we start off, let's have the attitude that we're building something so small that we could throw it away and start over if we're going down the wrong path. So the first thing I would do is I would go and I would basically try and figure out, and I would appoint one person to be sort of in charge of this. So you don't have all these meetings and stakeholders and all of this type of thing. Just make it communicated to this single person who in Scrum, we call them a product owner, right? That this person has control over this product and what's going to be built. And they're going to be responsible for coming up. What is the first iteration? What's the first thing that we're going to build? Okay, and then you want to demo that as soon as possible. Get that in front of users so they can start using it, right? It might be simple, might not really help them very much, but let them try and use it and let them experiment with it. Then you're going to take your next iteration and you're going to figure out, okay, what's the next most valuable thing that we could do? What is the most valuable and simple thing that we could get done? And you're going to build on to there. Now, this is where the practicality comes in. after doing this for a little bit, right, a few iterations, you're probably going to hit a point where you're either so right on the right track, that's good, and you're going to keep going and keep going down that path, or you're going to realize, whoops, you need to rewrite the entire thing and think about an architecture, right? At some point, an architecture is going to emerge, and it might be that your existing architecture can be modified and you're going to go down that path, or it might be that it's time for rewrite, but it doesn't matter because you haven't invested a lot of time, maybe a few weeks, and the rewrite will be simple because most of the work was, you know, figuring out exactly what to do and what to build. So that's where, you know, probably my thinking separates from a lot of people, is that I recommend going down that path. I'm not going to say that you just iterate your way to success. That doesn't happen. Sometimes you need to plan out an architecture, but you can't plan it out at the beginning either. You got to start building first and start seeing some kind of path and progress, and then you can develop an architecture from that. So that's really, really what my advice is. It's pretty simple, right? And you just keep on going forward from there, always making sure that you are always very quickly showing the work that you've completed to the customers and users who are going to use it and the stakeholders involved, and trying to corral all the stakeholders by one product owner, right? One person that represents that product, represents all those stakeholders. So you don't get multiple communications, you don't get debates, you don't get all of this type of politics that messes up a project. You need one point for the developers and for the QA people and for everyone on the team to look toward for any answers, any questions that they have about the project, and to really set, to be responsible for what's being created and for setting the expectations on that. And then, you know, you're gonna iterate early, you're gonna show early, and don't be afraid to scrap it, to start over, to change the architecture. And when it feels right, that's when you'll plan out the architecture. Well, hopefully that's helpful. Obviously, you know, I could go on for hours about this because it's a pretty deep topic, but I wanted to give you just a kind of a quick overview of what I think about this. If you'd like more details, feel free to email me. I do provide some consulting services around this. I have very limited availability, but I do provide that from time to time. And if you like this video, share it or subscribe to this channel. Take care.